Good morning. Thank you for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes, with Peter Piper Plus One. We have to give you a new name. As you learn more, it's got to become more pipe related. He needs a better title. Anyway, thank you so much for tuning in. I really appreciate it. We're a little over 98,000 subscribers this morning. Not really moving, but slowly moving to that 100,000 subscriber milestone. In any case, thank you so much. Really appreciate it. We're heading to a service call right now. Well, actually, we're already there. We actually already recorded it. I'm just making the intro. I'm just keeping it real. I've been going to this customer's home for about 6 years. A number of years ago, we actually replaced the double check valve, the backflow prevention device on the water main here. And every year we come here and we test it. All right. We're here again. We're going to do that. And then I'll get back to you at the end and give you a little outro. Smash that thumbs up button in advance and please consider subscribing. There's no cost or obligation. I really appreciate it.
All right, Peter. You ready?
I'm ready.
Remember how to do this?
A little. I've done it like three or four times.
Okay. Grab the little bungee. Okay. And first we're going to hang the backflow. Maybe from that pipe right there. Excellent. Perfect. Okay. So we're going to use the directions here. All right. Then we have this laminated piece of paper. This is for a reduced pressure zone. Mm-hmm. Right? Does it say reduced pressure zone? The easiest way to tell the difference between a double check valve. Uh-huh. And a reduced pressure zone is a reduced pressure zone called an RPZ, has a relief or discharge opening on it. It would normally be on the bottom of it here, and that's the easiest way of telling. This one does not have any relief on it, so it's a double check valve, and we're going to use these procedures right here. So for number one, read number one, determine direction of flow.
Direction.
So tell me the direction of flow here.
We're going up.
Correct. So we're starting from the street through the meter. We have a drain here. If this drain was here, actually, believe it or not, technically this instantly fails because this drain is not allowed to be here because it's an unapproved connection prior to the containment device. All right, it's an unapproved connection prior to the containment device that can be here. Mm-hmm. It cannot be there. So technically it instantly fails, but for purposes of testing and for education, we're going to continue testing this device. Okay. And I know that's used by the water company to flush out the service when they flush out fire hydrants and things like that. Okay. So we determine direction of flow. Number two.
Number two is close off number two shut valve.
Okay. Close number two shut valve. Show me number one.
This one.
Okay. Where's number two?
Okay.
All right. Close that. Next.
Number three is blow off test cocks 2 and 3 and 4 to eliminate any dirt or debris.
Perfect. So inside that little thing right here is your Phillips screwdriver. I mean, your multi-tool. Blow off test cocks 2, 3, and 4 to remove any debris from the connections. Confused?
So 2, 3, 4.
Yes. Just move those. You're going to get some water over there. Okay. So we're going to take off this little cap, that little cap, and that little cap. And you put your hand in front of it and just, you know, just crack it open a little bit to get any debris out of there, which is not there anyway.
Okay.
So a little crack. See, there you go. Do the next.
Okay.
And the last. This is one. This is 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now that we've blown off test cocks 2, 3, and 4, we're going to test check valve number one.
Okay.
Connect the high pressure hose A to test cock number two.
Okay.
So here is our backflow tester. This is the Watts TK9A. Right, and there's a little diagram right there. Right, we have high, low bypass. So this is high, right?
Mm-hmm.
That one on the bottom is low bypass. See?
Okay.
High, low bypass. Okay, so you're going to connect high pressure hose A
mm-hmm.
to test cock number two. Now you're going to connect low pressure hose B to test cock number three, which is the red hose off the TK9A, which is roughly $2,000.
Really?
Yeah, it went up in price a lot.
That's crazy.
It is very crazy. Okay. Now, we are going to open test cocks two and three. Before we do that, we're going to close all these valves. I always leave them open. All the time they're in storage. And I make sure that it's drained out to make sure nothing freezes. Okay. So now you're going to open test cocks two and three. Good. Okay. Next. Bleed air from high pressure hose through high side control valve A to bypass number C. Okay?
Okay.
So, we should get like a little towel or a little bucket because we're going to open up this valve and this, A and C, to drain out any air in the line.
Ready?
Open that up, A, and then C, and then get ready to close C. Okay, close it. Okay, I just want to do it for enough time just to get the air through. A and out through C.
Okay.
Okay. Now, we're going to close control valve A. Okay. Now, you're going to bleed air from the low pressure hose through control valve B and bypass C. So, all you're going to do is open up B. Open up B. A, B. B's the middle.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then you're going to open up C. Right, and then you're gonna close B and C. So close, okay, good. Now close B. Okay. Now, close valves B and C. Check valve number one must hold one PSI to pass test. We're at zero, something's wrong. Right?
All right.
So this testing procedure, no good, did not pass. So we're using the older style, which is still permissible. The same steps are the same, except high pressure hose goes to test cock number three. And we open test cock number three, which is open right there. Then we're gonna bleed the high pressure hose through A and B. So there's A, there's B. Oh, let me open up this valve. Okay, so we bleed air through test port number three through high pressure hose through side A to B. It stays pegged on the high side. Right, we're going to close shut off valve number one, which is right here. Needle should stay pegged on the high side, which it is. Right now, we're going to slowly open B until the needle drops to 2 PSID. So, I'm going to open up this until it drops to 2 PSID, right around there. That's close enough. Okay, now we're going to slowly open. We did that. We're going to open up test cock number two, which is right here. Okay. That's open, and we're still at 2 PSID. If it drops below, until needle drops below 2 PSID, if it drops below 1 PSI, check valve is faulty. So now we're going to close test cocks 2 and 3. 2 and 3. Okay. And we're going to open up shut-off valve number 1. Now we're going to test check valve number 2. We're going to take the high pressure hose and connected to test port number 4, which is right here. Okay. And we're going to open up test cock number 4. Okay. Now we're going to bleed the air through A and B. There's A is open. Here's B. Bleeding the air through that. Okay. We close that. Close shut off valve number 1. Open up B till it drops to 2 PSID. Right about there. Perfect. Even on the money. Now we're going to open up test valve, test cock number 3, which is right here. And it just barely moved. Saw that? And we're open. Okay. Check valve number 1 passed. Check valve number 2 passed. On the old school method. For whatever reason, it did not work. this did not pass with the new method, but both methods are permissible in New York State.
We're back! Perfect example of how I keep it uncut, unedited, and raw. We have the newer test procedures that I learned about 2 years ago. Yeah, 2 years ago when I took my renewal class for my New York State Backflow Prevention License. It's a little bit easier, but unfortunately it didn't work on this backflow prevention device, this Watts 3/4 inch double check valve. It didn't work. So, and I looked at the history. It was, we installed this one in 2020, and it was a new install, and it really should last more than a couple of years without having to take it apart and clean it. But you never know, you get some foreign debris stuck on there and those seats. But nonetheless, I used the earlier version, and it passed with flying colors. You know, the check valve number one held at 2 PSID. It did not move at all. And check valve number two dropped a little bit to a little bit below 2 PSID, but also passed. And the rule is that it has to stay above 1 PSID to be a functional check valve. So both valves tested, perfect. If we didn't use the other method, the device would have failed and an unnecessary expense and repair. In my opinion. Prove me wrong, ladies and gentlemen. If you test these kind of devices and there's multiple approved test methods and you only use one and it fails, what would you do? All right, let me get your thoughts and feedback in the comments section down below. And if you would like a copy of both the original and the newer test procedures, well, pause it at the time that I actually show the whole screen and make a screenshot of it. Or you can email me and I'll try to remember and I'll shoot you an email, a PDF. All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Till next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.